Hello everyone and good afternoon. I hope everyone can hear me at the back. Wave at me if you can. It would just be nice to know that I saw a wee hand going up. Thank you very much. Okay, so sixth year, it's an absolute pleasure to welcome you all here this afternoon. And it's nice to see you all again after we've not seen some of you for a wee while. So really great. You are looking resplendent in your various outfits. So I'm loving the hoodies, but equally I'm loving the uniform, guys. It looks amazing. Before we get started this afternoon, there's just a few wee sort of housekeeping points that I need to stress with you. So if you could just bear with me while I do that. This afternoon, we really do need to stay outside. Okay, so we are able to be out here in this area. There's one wee exception to that, which is later on we can go into the theatre for a little slideshow that Miss Kerr and Mr. McGee have put together for you. While we are here, I know that you're all sitting with each other and you've been socialising with each other, I'm sure, for many, many weeks and months. But we do need to remember that because we are in a school, we need to maintain the 2 metre distancing thing with adults, okay? So, sorry about that. Also, the toilets, if you do need to go to the loo this afternoon, you can only use the toilets there, just in order to keep everyone together. If you could do that, that would be excellent. If you are going inside, so if you're going inside for the theatre or to the toilets, I'm afraid you do need to put on your face masks. If you don't have one, of course, we've got many in Bannerman. I can also remind you that the rest of the school is here, apart from fifth year really, but the rest of the school is in this afternoon. They are very, very curious about what is going on. There's been a lot of interest in this event, but obviously we need to make sure that there's no daft behaviour that will lead to anyone else from the school getting into any kind of bother. So I'm trusting and relying upon you, sixth year, to just be as awesome as you usually are. If you still have your school iPad, and Mr. Cahoon did wave a long list of people's names at me, he says that you're not allowed to leave until you hand it in. So if you've got your iPad, he will be looking for those later on. And also to remind you that you also have to bring in the charger, which is very, very important. Okay, finally, I do have to tell you that we are filming this event so that we can share it with your families. If there is anyone who has, you know, really does not want to be filmed, then you need to make yourself known to Mr. McGee at some point so that we can do something clever about that. All right, so that's what that's just the kind of facts and figures, but I just had to go over all of that with you. I'm just going to also share with you what we are doing this afternoon. First of all, this part is kind of a sort of formal part of the afternoon. Your teachers want to say nice things about you. And I know that they've all written really nice things about each and every one of you, and they are very, very much looking forward to sharing that with the group of people here. So we would like you to bear with us while we give you lots of compliments, and take all those compliments as graciously as you can. We do have a little certificate for you all. It's like the awards ceremony today, guys. So you will need to come out when your name is called, and you will be getting your certificate from Miss Kerr. I also have to tell you that we are very delighted. We have got some performances this afternoon. We've got Elliot's going to perform. Scott may perform. We're still working on him. He's shaking his head, but I think you'll persuade him. And of course, we also have our resident band from fifth year who seem to have vanished. They will be performing later on. Okay, I think I've covered that. What's going to be happening. So I really want you to enjoy yourselves this afternoon, take lots of photos, use this as an opportunity to share your memories and enjoy your last time, your last day formally, I suppose, in Bannerman High School. I would like to say, as a head teacher in Bannerman, I want to thank you all for being a year group like no other year group we've ever had, because your experience of school has been like nobody else's. And what I would say to you is that, you know, the last 2 years have been very, very strange and weird, I think, for everybody. But you guys have come through it all so well. You're still smiling, and you show an amazing amount of resilience and determination. And it's been really lovely to see you over the past sort of half year, from January, when well, maybe not January, February, when people started to be able to come back in, and just see how hard you've worked. And I know that you are all keen to find out what your grades are and how well you've done in your qualifications. And I'm just really, really proud of all of you. You should be very proud of yourselves as you leave school and head out into the world. You've done with a lot, but you know that makes you stronger. And I know that you're going to go on and be a great success. And I want you to leave school remembering all the things that you've learned in the last couple of years about what it means to keep going when things are difficult. I don't want all your memories of Bannerman to be about lockdowns though, or face masks, or blue roll, which I'm quite sure you never want to see ever again. There's been a lot of things I know you've done while you've been at school, and I hope that you have enjoyed. Miss Kerr is going to say a few words later on, and I'm quite sure she will remind you of many activities and moments that she remembers and so on. But I would just like to share a few wee highlights of my own about this year group, because as I say, you're a very special group of young people. First of all, I don't think we can have this graduation today without mentioning our Dance Academy students. You guys were the first Dance Academy pupils, and here you are now in sixth year. And I would personally like to thank each and every one of you, no matter how long you were in the Dance Academy for all the memories I have of Bannerman Dance, because it's absolutely tremendous. And I would also especially like to thank you, especially people like Cara, who very patiently put up with me and my silly nonsense about flash mobs and other such ridiculous behaviours, and because it's embarrassing to see teachers doing things that they're really bad at. But you're so patient and you're so kind about everything that you do. So thank you all. I want to thank everyone who's taken part in any events in the school shows, choirs, all the musical performances, because they make the school a really special place to be in. So thank you all very much for that. The Malawi group, again, you're the last lot of young people from Bannerman able to go to Malawi. And one of my treasured photographs of the school is of Lee Sinclair holding that baby. It's the cutest photo in the world, and it's a really lovely one to have. So I always remember that. Also, you guys were one of the first lot of people who did what we called the BGE showcases. I don't know if you remember in the Games Hall, and everyone had got on their best outfits and showed off all the stuff that you had done. And that is a really important memory for me. But I think one of the things I liked about it best was all the boys in your year group, of which there are many, and you might see some photos of this later on, that were running about the school trying to find a blazer, because Miss Kerr told them that they couldn't come unless they had a blazer on. And I have to say to you boys, I can tell you now that a lot of those blazers you were wearing, they were definitely the girls' blazers. But never mind, you rocked the look, you looked really good, and it was a really happy day. And finally, I just want to say a special mention to my first year PSE class. I can see Erica sitting there right at the front, and Kirsty and Robin, and Ross Kinloch, and various other people that were all in that class. You were the last class I really had as a class, and it was actually really lovely to have you and to see you grow up through the school. So very special memories there for you guys. I know that you'll all have your own memories, and I hope that your memories of Bannerman are happy memories, and that when you leave the school, you talk fondly of us once you move on to all your careers and your amazing futures that you're going to have. Just remember that who you are is always going to be more important than what you have. That the behaviours and the deeds that you do will always mean more than the words that you say. And I just wish you all the very, very best. So thank you for coming this afternoon. So that's my wee speech over. And I'm now going to hand over to... Oh, thank you very much. I'm going to hand over now to something far more entertaining and enjoyable, and that's Ellie. So thank you very much, Ellie, for participating this afternoon. So a big round of applause for Ellie Schofield. Thank you. It's not easy to know. Everyone, so thank you very much, Ellie, and I wish you all the very best in the future, and I hope you keep singing. You will. Okay. Now, there's something else we need to do this afternoon before any merriment can begin, because Naomi and someone else, Kirsty, are coming up here now because they've got some, I believe, some awards to announce from some sort of poll that they did. I've told them to, they have to keep it family friendly. So they're going to come and do that just now, because I know that's what you really want to hear this afternoon.
Emma Donaldson. Dad of the year goes to Alex O'Neill. Most likely to win the lottery but lose a ticket goes to Lewis Morrison. Most likely to be famous with Sophia. Best singer, Ellie Schofield. Nicest voice was Emma Donaldson. Most likely to run the country was Alex O'Neill. I'll let you do something.
We got told to take this one out, but the person who won it is okay with it. So best ginger goes to Demi McLaughlin. Best hair boy goes to Thomas Gay. Best hair girl goes to Brooke Pearson. The best couple, it's a joint, it was actually exactly even. So it's Kirsty McAdam, Reese Laurie, and it's Beth McFadden and Thomas Gay. Right, the funniest is also a joint one, so it goes to Lewis Moulton and Jack White. Most likely to be a reality TV star goes to Holly Jackson.
Do you want to do some? Right, most stylish.
Right, most stylish boy was Lewis Moore. Most stylish girl was Robin Allen. Most likely to be an influencer was Brooke Pearson. Most likely to marry a celebrity, Courtney Murray. Biggest drama queen, Lewis Hughes. most fun to be around was Aidan Kay. Person with all the gossip goes to Ailey Miller. Most successful would be Abby Mockery. Best laugh with boy was Lee Sinclair. The best laugh with girl was Abby Wallace. Most likely to be a footballer, Josh Learmonth.
So the life of the party went to Mark Donaldson. The most likely to cure a disease was Nadia. The best therapist / advice giver was Hayley Miller. The smartest was Sue Singh. The kindest was Beth McFadden. The most posh was Abigail. The loudest was Demi McLaughlin. The quietest was Mia McLeod. The best behaved, Mark Donaldson. The class clown was Zane. The PE teacher's favourite was Emma Donaldson and Ewan Hill. Best English, Aaron Long. Best at math was Arash. Best dancer was Sophia. Best smile boy was Reese Laurie. Best smile girl was Samantha Doherty. Who is our life together? Dan Digweed. Most likely to move abroad was Caitlin Mackay. Most likely to live the longest was Lewis Morrison. The biggest diva was Cara. The most laid back was Nico. The best all-rounder was Camden Cairns. The most mature was Raina Curry, and the most immature was Jack White. Most likely to buy IDs when they're 30 went to Robin Allen. What are the next ones? I'll tell you what you can
take right. The one with the beat in the brains was Naomi. Best bromance is Reese, Laurie and Jamie Paul. Always late to class was Anne Wallace. Always asleep in class was Anne Lung. Always drinking coffee or Red Bull, of course, was Jennifer Kemp. Most opinionated was Lee Sinclair. The most accident prone was Kyle Crichton. Most upbeat actress was Lucy Connor.
Prom Queen went to Kirsty McAdam. Your prom king was Reese Lawrie. Your most sarcastic was Jennifer Kim. Most likely to answer back was Ross Lennox. The couple that never was Caitlin McKay and Ewan Hill. Your best partner for a pub quiz was Lee Sinclair. Your best double act was Robin Allen and Sophia Chirk.
So the best artist was Amy Parker, best musician Scott Geddes, the best scientist was Katie Smith, and your we like teacher awards, so kindest teacher, there was three that they all put together was Miss Campbell, Mr. Bristol and Mr. Ogilvy. Strictest teacher was Mr. Jones. Funniest teacher, Mr. Reynolds, and most laid back was Mr. Kelly.
Okay guys, it's starting to spit with rain. We managed to get through the whole ceremony. I had a speech prepared, but I won't say it because it's going to start to rain. I'm sure you'll be very pleased and relieved. I just want to say something really quickly. I am very, very proud of every single one of you. It's been a tough couple of years, but you've made it through, and I know you're going to go on and be successful in whatever you choose to do in life. I've loved the little chats I've had over the years, the little random conversations, and watching you grow into confident young adults. It's been an absolute pleasure. So what's going to happen now is we've got a slideshow in the theatre, which is going to be kind of on a loop, so there'll be two showings of that. There's only 50 people at a time allowed in the theatre, due to, we won't mention it. And we've also got cake, some juice and crisps, which I know a couple of people will be really happy about because they've been starving from the start. So can I have a round of applause for the class of 2021? Well done, guys.
Yeah.